there, everybody. This is Ostoni, and welcome to Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. We are still going to be covering the DLC 3 material, and we will be doing so as my own character, Ostoni, because it's been a while since I took him out and about, showed him off to everybody to see, and now you will be able to see him in all of his full glory as he goes through and proceeds to beat the dog shit out of this DLC. And I am pretty confident about that because of a couple of reasons. One, I have new skills to play with that have come from various mods and everything like that. And you know what? I think I'm actually gonna go over some of them before I really go into it, because there's gonna be one or two that I wanna change. Maybe one or two that I wanna change. Or well, nah, never mind. Fuck it. I just wasted time. And blah 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 blah. I'll save Bojack moves for well, wait a minute. Why did I just do oh my god.
Greetings.
Blah, blah. Let's see. Okay, this time I got the right one. This one's gonna be good. Alright, so I'm gonna be playing as my own character leading us off, and I will recruit characters from mods that I have covered in the past. And for the first team that I'm going to pick, who should I pick? Let's see. I know you guys just saw somebody who you're interested in, but we're gonna have to wait on that for just a little bit. I like to do shit in order. Let's see. First, let's go ahead and have a Super Saiyan 4 party up in here. Let's see. Let's have Trunks.
I've got to set an example.
Okay, good for you, Trunks. Good for setting an example. Cool. You're not a nerd at all, right? Let's see. The next one. Let's go ahead and do Bardock. Even though he doesn't say anything, I still like this version of Bardock. I don't think there's another version of Super Saiyan 4 Bardock. I wouldn't want to retread old territory on mods, so if you guys bring up to me like, hey, there's a another version of like this character that you did, no offense to you, no offense, but pretty much whenever I do a mod that's based on a character, unless it's like just vastly improved, there's not much chance that I'm gonna redo a mod based on a character.
I ran so far away and left my behind again.
No, why'd you do that? But it's cool, you have your Super Saiyan 4 version and Bardock helping. Oh dang. God, fucking Trunks, you're such a bitch. Just poking the bear, goddammit. Alright, and now it's time for the Xenoverse 2 Facebook Man, Myth, and Legend. It's Super Saiyan 4 Starter! In action! Oh shit, I could've got him. Oh, I could've got him. But that's okay. Because I have moves to show off to you guys. Like this one! BAM! I think he blocked that one. But that one's Gigantic Destruction, and where you get that one from is Xenoverse 2 mods has a... And I say that specifically because I know that there's another popular modder that has this character. But just on Xenoverse2mods.com, you can go and download, they're calling her Kali, basically the female Broly that's gonna be, in Dragon Ball Super. She, has a custom, finisher, and that is it, the gigantic, destruction. So if you want that move, download her, comes with it. You can use it, I think, on just about anybody. Because, from my understanding, it is the final Kamehameha with Broly's ki type, and it only costs 3 bars, and I don't know if there's damage subtracted off of it to compensate or not. I would very much like to figure that out, but like, it's something that's been, that I've been kind of curious about, but at the same time, if I had to sacrifice a little bit of damage, that's okay, because I'm a fan of the final Kamehameha, just as a move in general, just because of how fucking cool it looks. Let's see, that one's the legendary shot. And basically, that move was made individual and kind of wrapped into a Zycor mod, I believe. Or no. What it is it's a move.
So you finally get it.
And the picture that's with it is Zycor doing it. So that's kind of where the confusion lies in it, I believe. I think I'll actually put some links in the description for the moves I'm going to show you guys. Because that's two. I got one more. Just one more. Alright, so let's see how Trunks... Ooh.
Trunks, come spar with me for a bit.
Okay.
Alright, let's get to it.
Oh, really?
Super Saiyan 2 as well.
Okay. That's cool. I'll go Super Saiyan 4, legendary Super Saiyan 4. Because that's actually the name of this form that I made, is fucking legendary Super Saiyan 4. That's right. Ooh, you only caught me with the tail end of that, Goku. How about this? Oh, god. Oh, I didn't think it would work. Kind of wishful thinking. That's fine. Alright, then. Let's see if I can get him there. Ooh. Kinda. I think if you really want the damage from that move to come out, like, you really want to hit him with the last part of that move. That's where the damage really starts to stack on. And we kind of got him with the beginning, the middle. We couldn't get the end part. And 10 times Dragon Fist. Bam. Oh, okay. Super Saiyan. I was about to be like, why doesn't it do any damage?
Amazing. A Super Saiyan 2 levels beyond Super Saiyan? You really
it sounds like a child made it up, right? Weird, huh? Yeah, but then again, you could say a lot of the power-ups, like in Dragon Ball Z, kind of sound a bit childish. That's the thing, it's the power of fantasy! Oh. Come here. No. Beat the shit out of you. Ooh. I got him with some of it. I know his stamina kind of took a hit and wasn't able to recover. And a legendary shot. Aw, oh, fuck. Now, to let you guys in on a little something, the particular thing about legendary shot, there's actually nothing special about it. All it is perfect shot, but the animation's different. So if you want a little bit of a different look to your, to the animation of perfect shot, it's perfect. No pun intended. I like it because it's just basically like, whoa. And then you're all like, yeah. So I think it's more along the lines of like you do the Big Bang Attack animation, but you do the perfect shot. I'm guessing that the ultimate finish for this will probably be Goku and Vegeta going Super Saiyan Blue. Kind of calling it. I think I already have my question of the day figured out. Now that I think about it, it's not too bad a good one. I think it's alright. Alright. For those of you who were also wondering this question, where my transformation actually scales. Basically, my transformation is just Potential Unleashed, but since I've played around with the transformation editor a little bit that comes with like the patcher and the installer and everything like that, I think I may, and I don't know this for sure because I haven't tried it yet, I think I actually made it to where I get the Super Saiyan Snap Vanish whenever I do a chargeable beam attack. Like I said, I can't swear to it. I really need to try it because that's one of the things I wanted to check off.
Way to go, Trunks. You've come a long way.
Uh-oh.
All on your own.
Thank you very much.
But listen, now...
You better not be satisfied with your current level.
No!
Uh-oh. Here it comes. Oh, we're gonna... Something tells me we're going to space. That just sounds right to me. Well, shit. I think I didn't mean to go that way. I went the wrong way, didn't I? I probably went the wrong way. Fuck. Okay, so let's get through this. Let's see what's going on here. Wait. Oh, okay, so we can go. Why would they make them both green, though? Like, make the one green that I'm supposed to go through. Or make it, like, red or something to indicate danger. There's a damn fire truck going by my house. Son of a bitch.
All right, Trunks.
Yep.
This time I'm not
called
coming
it
back.
What is that for?
This is called Super Saiyan Retint. The fanboys love it. Sorry, everybody who likes it. That's just my opinion of it. You can have your opinion about Super Saiyan 4 too. That's my opinion of Super Saiyan Blue. It's just Super Saiyan Retain, and I think it's just a lazy way to fucking do an awesome transformation that's supposed to be god level. I mean, god level, and you don't, like, make a major change to your appearance. It just kind of baffles me.
You get to go against god-level powered people, and it's going to be epic, and you get to fight the god of destruction and train alongside him, fight immortals that are pretty much just nigh indestructible, and you're going to be god-level.
Alright, cool. What's gonna be the difference in this? Is my hair gonna, like, spike up? Am I gonna get, like, crazy lightning around me?
You're going to be blue! Congratulations! Now leave me alone, I'm going to go fucking read my pornography magazines because I don't know how the internet is made because this whole damn anime is fucking based around the central concept that we're like in the fucking...
Well, wait a minute, actually that makes sense because the anime was made like a pretty long time ago. Super isn't. They've updated some of the technology in Super to kind of mimic stuff from nowadays, though. Alright. Eh. There we go. Okay. I needed that. Sometimes the Super Saiyan 4 needs help. Don't you judge me. Don't you judge me! Ooh. You did my move, sir. That's usually what I would do for my solution. Alright, let's see if I can get you. Oh god. And. Oh fuck. Alright. I think I might actually have to make each one of these parallel quests one single episode. Because this isn't easy. I know the DLC 1 weren't easy either. DLC 2 was easier, I think, for the parallel quest, in my opinion. This isn't bad as far as challenge. Like, I can beat this. I know I can. But if Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta is this much of a challenge, and I still need to go up against Super Saiyan Blue Goku. Ooh, damn. A hit with all of it. Oh, that was a nice chunk of damage. Oh. Yeah, they aren't doing much to Goku, it doesn't look like. I'm hoping that one of the conditions for us losing isn't Trunks dying. Because that would suck. I don't want to play babysitter if I don't have to. There we go. Oh, shit. I wish I could fucking combo that. I don't want to combo that so bad. And I think you could still even snap Vanish out of that. Like, so it's... So it's not impossible. Like, I mean, it should line up. I don't know. Hitboxes are weird. And fuck. Oh shit, got him! Yeah! Hit both of my big moves on Super Saiyan Blues. How you like me now? Oh, wait a minute. That's right. I kinda do have a score to settle with Goku, if I really think about it. Because Goku keeps pushing his nose into my business, whether it's Mira or whether it's Hit. Oh shit. Yep, I'll do that. Okay, good chunk of damage. Oh, damn it. I thought I was the one that died. Nope.
Good. Wow.
Trunks died.
You're the best, almost. Okay.
So you can't win, and we got Future Mize boots. We got 5 TP medals. That's not too bad. At least we know what we gotta do to win, and that's the important thing. But let's see. Goddamn. You know what, I think that's good enough. I mean, I didn't get the actual ending, but you guys know how and what to expect from said ultimate ending. And just out of curiosity, what would we have even gotten? Is it even worth it? Holy shit, it really wasn't worth it to get the ultimate ending on that. It wasn't. You get Future Mize clothes and hat, which if you want those, good for you. Okay. And then you can't win as a Z-Soul, and we pretty much... We got the... Probably the most useful thing for probably everybody. Actually... Before I go... We'll, go ahead and see... Yeah, I know someone's gonna point it out. I don't give a shit about the obvious thing that... is on my equipment screen. Let's see, where is it? You can't win. Okay, Ultimate Gohan's Super Soul. It's a rush type, so that's awesome. Whoa! Hold on. Hold. 1 minute. Could... Because my technique, my transformation technically is Potential Unleashed. Although I don't think it'll work because now the name's changed and I changed a value or two about it. But that is actually a really good Super Soul And that is good enough reason to do that quest, just to get that. Like, if you're, like, another race or something like that that's not a Saiyan, or maybe if you just like to use Potential Unleash, that's pretty good. I would use that, like, if I still was only using Potential Unleashed to get into Super Saiyan 4. But that's going to be it for this video. Sorry we couldn't get a victory. Maybe next time, but we got pretty much everything that we could have gotten out of there besides a full set of fucking clothes, which that would have cost, like, caused a lot of fucking time and shit. But I do have an interesting question of the day for you guys. DLC 4, coming out around June, they say. What are your top three moves that you want to see from that expansion? I have an idea on at least one, maybe two, but I want to see what you guys have to say about that. So thank you guys for watching. This is Stony signing off. Grrr!